The last 5 years of my career, I was asked to take a corporate position. And I was asked to look at the portfolio of DuPont's R&D. And it was about $2.2 billion of R&D at the time, across 12 highly diverse global businesses and a fairly large central research organization. And I was asked to kind of see what I can do to help improve the innovation processes, the productivity of that R&D, that innovation investment that was used across these businesses and central research. When I first got into this role, one of the things that I saw was the discontinuity of all the processes. So a good example was Stagegating, which is utilized, you know, in most corporations. I added up, we had about 26 flavors of Stagegating going across the corporation. And it was becoming apparent the reason we weren't collaborating effectively was we weren't speaking the same language. So one of my first tasks was to come up with a corporate Stagegate framework where all the businesses can adopt and map into. But you know, in some cases, some businesses have very strong Stagegating, had a lot of gates. What we asked them to do was just map into the corporate process. But the other businesses, actually, it turned out that by developing this corporate process, they saw a real benefit, so they adopted the corporate process. So within a year or two, we had a common language that we could speak. So we could, if one business was talking about a product in stage two, we could relate to what that meant to another business that was in stage two. And recognize DuPont's portfolio was highly diverse. It was everything from crop genetics to food nutrition to electronic materials to polymers. So you had all kinds of different technologies, products, all different kinds of life cycles, ranging from 10 to 15 years to 18 months. So the idea of establishing a common Stagegate framework kind of got everybody a common language. But the next task that I was asked was came down through the CTO, through the CEO of the corporation. And the challenge was, we're investing $2.2 billion of R&D. What are we getting? How do we measure the return on investment for this? Okay. And again, I took the task on of looking at ways of finding how to measure this overall investment in a corporation. And the way it started, again, was kind of doing some fundamental research, talking to outside experts, and there's been all kinds of theories about how to manage or how to measure R&D from the top down. But you know, through the research I did, what I effectively found out was that all R&D is not really treated equally. So I created four categories of R&D. Okay, just like common Stagegate framework, but this in this case, it was portfolio measurement. And the four categories were one, discovery and early stage development, where this is all this front end activity, high risk, a lot of activity. The second category is what I call projects that create top line growth to the corporation. And when I speak about top line growth, I talk about projects that are creating growth year over year. So revenue that grows year over year, and you subtract basically the cannibalization. And in that category, it could be range anything from very transformative to highly differentiated projects. But the point is, those projects are creating top line growth. The third category is what I would call product extensions. Those are the incremental product developments that are used, you know, in a corporation. Some of those are applications development, some of those are product enhancements, some of those support kinds of products. But what I found in my kind of investigation is many of those projects were not necessarily creating top line growth. They're really there to kind of maintain and offset the competitive fade in a business. And then the last category is what I would call maintain and support. So that's the kind of R&D you supply to manufacturing, for regulatory support, for service support, et cetera. But anyway, we created these four categories of R&Ds and some very explicit metrics around how to measure those. In fact, I'll give you an example. To get into that second category, those top line growth projects, we have very strict financial metrics of how to get in there. You had to, and we had thresholds about how much revenue they had to create or how much NPV, et cetera. So this was not a subjective test of how to measure things. It was either you were in or out. But anyway, through that kind of methodology, we were able to get a really good idea and categorization of the portfolio across, again, 12 highly diversified businesses, you know, $2.2 billion of R&D, and be able to show some patterns and gaps and categories that we could maybe take some corrective action on.